Carolyn Dube here. What's the play for today? Well, why? It's stencils in honor of Mary Beth Shaw's birthday. Now, I'm going to be sharing with you in this video how I let my stencils do the heavy lifting.
So what do I mean by letting my art supplies do the heavy lifting? Well, what I mean is, like, when I use a gel plate and stencils together, they grab each other. They're kind of attracted to each other, and it'll hold the stencils in place exactly where I want them. So here, as I'm repositioning these castle towers for my Once Upon a Time set, they're going to stay right where I put them once I decide where I want them. And I have the freedom to go at an angle or straight up and down, a little angle, a lot of angle. And I love that I have that flexibility because it really depends on my mood. Today, it's a bit of a cattywampus day, so I've got those towers going every which way. Anywhere that you put your stencils on here, that's going to keep the paint from going in those places. So as I'm putting lots of color here on the gel press plate, I'm going to end up with this very colorful background all around where those castle towers are. And when I take the print where those towers are right now, that's going to be completely white and plain. These stencils are part of a set that includes these five masks, plus the stencil that goes around them, as well as little miniature castle towers. And you can check out what they all look like over on Stencil Girl's website at StencilGirlProducts.com. And by the way, they've got a gazillion other stencil designs over there too if you haven't checked out their website. Now, I want the sky all around these castle towers to be loaded with lots of color, so that's why I put a lot of colors here on the gel plate. And then it's just simply a matter of taking your brayer and moving that color all around until the plate is wonderfully covered. And you'll notice that the stencil towers, they're not moving one little bit. Even as I'm rolling that brayer on top of them, they are staying right where they are because that gel plate is grabbing them and holding them in place. Now you might be wondering, exactly how much paint do you need to do this? Well, that's the cool part about gel printing, is it's not about an exact amount of paint. It's extremely forgiving. If you use a lot of paint, you get one kind of look. If you use less paint, you get a different kind of look. If you've never gel printed before, you might be wondering, is this a little or a lot of paint? And this is a lot of paint. I like to get lots of it on there. I like the look from having all that color happening. And you're going to see in the print how all these colors have played together, blended together, to create a look that I could not create if I was just using a paintbrush. If you've seen many of my videos before, you might know that I'm an impatient person. And I like things to go quickly, which is why I love combining gel plates and stencils. Because in one pull, I'm going to get this whole thing done, all of this stenciled, all of that pattern in there, all of that color. Now, once I've got it loaded up the way I want, then I'm going to peel those tower masks off. The paper that I'm going to be using is a 90-pound cardstock, and not because that's the best kind to use, it's just the kind I really enjoy using. Whatever kind of paper you enjoy using, be it copy paper, cardstock, scrapbook paper, those all work for taking gel prints. This one just happens to be what I enjoy. So once I'm sure I've got great contact between the paper and the plate, then it's time to lift it up and see what's waiting for us. So now there is a colorful rainbow sky all around these castle towers. Well, thanks so much for joining me for a little stencil play today. Now, if you'd like more ideas of ways to use stencils, be sure to subscribe to the Stencil Girl YouTube channel. And check out their website, as well as their blog, Stencil Girl Talk, for more ideas and inspiration.